did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's still private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it. 5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the wheels suspended. I told them what I told them. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. Ay, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was top, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in. I've been on 10-10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I got it again and again. Who was the dummy to doubt? I'm the coldest around, but he folding again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. This was the scene a moment ago as the Bears emerge from their tunnel. Ready for football are they, and ready for football are we, as the Bears get set to match up with the Green Bay Packers.
O'Donnell to kick off for Chicago.
It's a rivalry that dates back to 1921. The Packers and Bears are underway from Chicago.
And this will make it into the end zone, and they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25.
This is Aaron Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. So he got three and one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else.
On the carry.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second and nine. Rodgers, he'll get this to Lazard.
Rodgers,
that throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 14 yards, good for a Packer first down. So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 43. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Give him back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another first down. They'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 28-yard line.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Working from the gun, Rodgers. He's got the hook up to Lazard. They'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
Going to try and throw on third down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jamin Johnson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. But no doubt, a very disappointing end to what was a pretty strong opening drive.
They had 3 points in their back pocket. It was there for them. If you don't like what you see, just throw it away. Make sure you get those points on the board. Don't get too greedy. He forced it there. You saw the end result.
And he's going to get this from the 6 out to the 12. A pickup of 6 as they double their workspace.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4 at the 12-yard line.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Now it's Trubisky. It's caught. It's Miller. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
At the 18-yard line.
A play fake to Montgomery. Now Trubisky. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun, Trubisky. He's going to dump that off to his running back, Cohen. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15.
Complete.
It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. Tyler Irvin back deep. We're scoreless after one.
First quarter with no score.
The Packers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a 1st and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your play.
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Touchdown, Packers. Aaron Jones, 56 yards. And the Packers are able to strike quickly for 6. and it's good to make it 7-0 Packers.
Makes the score Packers 7, Bears nothing. Mason Crosby to kick off for Green Bay.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordero Patterson. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30.
The Bears take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Trubisky now off the bootleg, rolling to his left. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Kevin King, the former Washington Husky there defensively.
But let's go back to the start of the season talk, Charles. We talked about some 2-0 and 0-2 teams. You mentioned Arizona, maybe a good surprise. Houston, a bad surprise. Any other teams a surprise at this point to you?
Well, I think that I would look at the Los Angeles Rams right out of the gate. At home against Dallas, opening their new stadium, many thought Dallas would go out west and beat them. That didn't happen. Then how about the Rams going on the road this week and beating Philadelphia and decisively? This looks like a Rams team that finished 9-7 last year. It has designs on challenging for the division title. And one other team I would throw in there is a little bit of a surprise. Just by how it's gone down, how about Atlanta? I know it's tough against Seattle, tough against Dallas. Seattle was at home, but they got jumped on by Seattle. And in the Dallas game, they just gave away. That's a team that should be at worst 1-1 right now. Now looking at 0-2 and have a lot of questions.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down. He'll leave it for Cohen, complete. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. It's a pickup of 10 and a Bears first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Trubisky to throw again. This is a catch by Ted Ginn. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
First and 10 at the 22-yard line.
On first down, Trubisky. And his throw is incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So after the incompletion, second and 10 from the 22. Again, it's Trubisky. And that'll be incomplete. Trubisky took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Green Bay up to the task there in coverage and forcing a fourth down. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Well, that's something of a pick-me-up, and the offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put three on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it, those 3 points, that's not going to solve all their problems either.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. To throw is Rodgers. He completes it to Jones. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
Complete to Aaron Jones. A 5-yard pickup on the play.
And 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coaches. Two-minute drill.
And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll bring up fourth down. On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. Back deep, Tariq Cohen. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line.
Absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
A good start to the drive here as that's caught out on the left side. And he's out right at the 25. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
On first and 10, it's Trubisky. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It's a pickup of 10 and a Bears first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to run.
And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Throwing once more, it's Trubisky. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
He completes this into the hands of Miller. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 21. A gain there of 21 yards.
21-yard line.
Now Trubisky on first down. And he completes it to Cohen. And he's down inside the 5 at the 4 before he's out of bounds. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Another Bears first down. First and goal at the 4-yard line.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll run with Montgomery. And he gets halfway there from the 4 to the 2 on a gain of 2. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. From the 2 now, second and goal. And he'll get into to the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Mitchell Trubisky in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bears have taken the lead.
I'd have to say that for him, that was an all-encompassing drive because it was his arm that got his team down to that point, but his legs that finished the deal. Give him credit for making it happen.
Eddie Pinheiro now for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7.
Makes the score Bears 10, Packers 7. O'Donnell to kick off for Chicago.
So just 8 ticks remaining here in the first half as they'll kick this one away.
Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here.
The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 40-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half.
Fielded in the end zone.
And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 16-yard line.
Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games, and we're seeing a pretty good one right now. Hotly contested in the third quarter. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
And 10 at the 42-yard line.
Trubisky, and that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Well, CD, unfortunately some somber news across the league in week two coming from New England Patriots running back James White, because his parents were in a car crash and his father Tyrone, captain of the Miami-Dade Police Department, passed away in that accident, and his mother Lisa also sustained critical injuries. So it was obviously a tough one. James White did not play in the game on Sunday, but we did see the outpouring of support from around the National Football League and how this really is one big family.
Yeah, he was really embraced, as you mentioned, by the National Football League. We saw social posts from plenty of players around the league, including Tom Brady, former teammate of his with the New England Patriots. We saw an outpouring in terms of, you know, other guys around the league, J.J. Watt, who played with him in college at Wisconsin. And not only that, how about his own teammates? Devin McCourty scored a touchdown against Seattle and ran up and told the camera, hey, 2-8, we're thinking about you, we love you. And the rest of the guys chimed in from there. And the Patriots organization offered to fly him home on the private jet. He stayed with his team, stayed in their embrace, and now he has to go and face the difficult task of saying goodbye to his dad and tending to his mom. But he's got plenty of support from around the league, from the Patriots, and, of course, his own family.
They go play action with Trubisky. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
We don't talk about it very often, but sometimes there's a dip in intensity when you start the second half, which can manifest itself in some sloppy tackling. And how about right there? He ran right through that weak tackle attempt.
They go play action. Trubisky. Flushed out right. And he's going to keep it here. And down inside the 15 he goes. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
First down, a run with Cohen. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That was a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
On second and 7, Trubisky. He's going to go down, sacked right around the 17. Preston Smith just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Now Trubisky on 3rd and long. And that is caught. Touchdown, Bears. Tariq Cohen there to make the grab as the Bears push further out in front. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
And he'll bang that one through.
Makes the score Bears 17, Packers 7.
After the touchdown, on is Pat O'Donnell to send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Offense ready to get their next drive underway. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing and try and get back to where you were to start the half.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Oh, trying to get that to Adams, but that's intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And he will score. Touchdown, Chicago.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Now Trubisky will lead the Bears up to go for two.
Trying to run it in with Montgomery.
And he will get into the end zone to bump the lead up to three scores. And they turned the pick six into a pick eight with that two-point conversion.
I love how you upsell. That is outstanding right there. What a big-time play. Big switch in how this game was going, and then they capitalized a little bit on top.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got...
And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Kyle Fuller. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. So their woes on offense continue. That's the second pick thrown here in the third quarter.
And we know it was ill-advised, but that was an opportunity to help them get back into the game. Instead, he throws another interception, and now their task is even tougher.
After the interception, here's Trubisky. They'll roll him out right. And now he's going to use his legs. And I think the ball's out. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and 1 yard. 2nd and short now following the fumble. Play action. It's Trubisky on the move to his left. He's going to take off with it. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. Maybe not exactly what they had in mind, but that scramble good for 6 and a first down.
1st and goal at the 5-yard line.
They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only 1 yard on the pickup there. 2nd and goal.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. On 2nd and goal. Trubisky escaping the pressure right. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can. But this is 3rd and goal.
From the gun, it's Trubisky. Pressure now, and he's going to go down. Sack back around the 8. Rashawn Gary drops him for a 4-yard loss there, and that brings up 4th down. The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on 4th and goal. They'll try and throw for it with Trubisky. And it is incomplete. They had the play call on 4th and goal, but it's dropped in the end zone. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their 4th pick of the game. Instead, 2nd down. The throw over the middle taken in. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. 12 yards there and a 1st down.
1st down, Packers.
Rodgers now on 1st down. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6.
A 6-yard pick.
From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4.
26-yard line.
Pressure and he's taken down. A Bear sack.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. Rodgers now, after the sack, he'll lead the pack up on third and long.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off around the 27. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
That interception may be the exclamation mark on what really all around has been a good performance.
A fantastic performance. They will enjoy film session. They're great, should be very good on this one. And I think the next time the offense gets the ball, I just think about running it and getting the clock done and getting the heck out of here.
And by the way, semantics here, but before the grammar police come after me, I think it's exclamation point, not mark, right?
You're asking me? Seriously?
Yeah, you're smarter than me. Everybody knows that.
Listen, I go with what you say, my man.
From the 21, it's second and 10. From the shotgun is Trubisky. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Josh Jackson. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line, and that's where the return stops. So they get the takeaway, but that's just step one. They still have a lot of work to do.
But they don't want to focus on that now. Now it's about getting the ball in the end zone and hoping they can take it away again.
Yeah, still a three-score game, though, fourth quarter.
This one complete to Devin Funchess.
7 yards, the pickup there. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time, down three scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their two-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win? Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
It's caught, Jones. And they do finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 41. It's a big play for the Pack on third. 41 yards. Rodgers now on first down. Looking deep for Adams. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Tashawn Gibson. And a good return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line.
That is now five interceptions that he has thrown in this ball game. If I asked you to speculate what's possibly going on in his head, what would you say?
Well, if he's as mentally strong as I believe he is, he understands that not all these picks have been his fault. You know, some of the throws, yes, but there have been a good number of them where he hasn't been helped by his own receivers, and they've turned into interceptions. So he knows if he keeps firing, perhaps good things can happen, not just in this game, but especially in later ones.
At the 35-yard line.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. Eluding the pressure right. The connection made. It's Graham. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. This will be a loss of three and now a much tougher third down looming. A play fake to Montgomery. Now Trubisky. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line.
Oh, Trubisky going to throw. Looking deep downfield. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Trying to get it to Tariq Cohen out of the backfield. But it'll be second down. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down.
And 10.
And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. So this one in the win column for the Chicago Bears. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever. Whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Bears get the win at home as we say so long from Soldier Field.
I heard a flare gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none, I'm stuck in my way.